Corpus Christi. Epístola de Santo Kate, está aquí en front, San Paul de Romans. Taken from St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brethren, I myself have received from the Lord what I also delivered to you. The Lord Jesus, on the night in which he was betrayed, took bread and giving thanks, broke and said, "Take and eat. This is my body which shall be given up to you. Do this in remembrance of me." In like manner also the cup, after he had supped, saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood. Do this as often as you drink it in remembrance of me. For as often as you shall eat this bread and drink the cup, you proclaim the death of the Lord until he comes. Therefore, whoever eats this bread and drinks the cup of the Lord unworthily will be guilty of the body and blood of the Lord. But let a man prove himself, and so let him eat of that bread and drink of the cup. For he who eats and drinks unworthily, without distinguishing the body of the Lord, eats and drinks judgment to himself." We stand up to hear the Holy Gospel is taken from St. John. At that time, Jesus said to the crowds of the Jews, "My flesh is food indeed, and my blood is drink indeed. He who eats my flesh and drinks my blood abides in me, and I in him. As the living Father has sent me, and as I live because of the Father, so he who eats me, he also shall live because of me. This is the bread that has come down from heaven. Not as your father ate the manna and died, he who eats this bread shall live forever." My Father and Son and Holy Ghost, amen. Take a seat, please. And we will with yours and give thanks to Father Pfeiffer and Father Hugo for the invitation. We hear the seminary. The future of the church. It's a great joy because Corpus Christi is the feast of the priest for excellence. Corpus Christi to give the bread. It's to give our Lord Jesus Christ himself coming from heaven after sacrificing himself at the altar on the altar of the cross at Mass. After the renewal of his sacrifice. Sacrifice of the Good Friday with renewal. The same sacrifice of our Lord on Calvary at Mass without shedding of the blood. That is the real sacrifice of our Lord Jesus Christ, who after sacrificing himself gives his body and blood to eat, that we may eat it, may eat his blood and his body. It's exactly for what the priest preparing himself and at the seminary, for the seminary to become priest. I want to point out to our dear seminarians the holiness, the preparation, the virtues, the purity that they had to acquire in order to be able to bring down our Lord from heaven for his sacrifice and to give our Lord Jesus Christ himself communion, his own body and his own blood. Not even the angels are able to do it. Not even Our Lady was able ever to give Holy Communion. So the great Saint Thomas Aquinas, who was the one who wrote the Mass that we are hearing today, the depth of the theology of the Blessed Sacrament, Corpus Christi, gives us an insight of the Gospel, which says, who eats me and my body, my blood, I will abide in him and he will abide in me. For it is the union with our Lord Jesus Christ, the most intimate, the most closer possible. His body is united to our body, his blood to our blood, his soul to our soul, his divinity to our humanity. Our Lord wants to be united to us so intimately united to us. Should increase our love for our Lord through the faith in his presence, in the real presence. This feast of Corpus Christi should be increasing in our souls this tremendous love that our Lord wants that we have towards him. We should ask in this feast an increase in love for our Lord Jesus Christ. An increase in receiving him in a more worthy manner. Ever more with beauty and with holiness. Exhorting also the seminarians to hear Mass as if we're the only Mass, to hear Mass, to be present at Mass, present at Mass as if we're the last Mass in their lives. Never take it for granted that you will have Mass, but that Mass will be there on a daily basis. When we take routine at coming at Mass or receiving Holy Communion is when we start falling down, start being lukewarm, falling in virtues, and this is why the modernism has fallen so low, because they started losing respect upon our Lord Jesus Christ. They started looking at this holy sacrifice as something human, something that they deserve or that they were having for granted. Started having a lukewarmness, of course, and after they started changing everything. So I want to exhort the seminarians, our dear seminarians, to for this love for the Holy Sacrifice of the Mass, for our Lord Jesus Christ, his Eucharistic presence, his real presence, so that we never lose this faith, this love for our Lord Jesus Christ. Maybe fed always in an increasing manner so that we may be able to have a good priest for this love and for the Eucharist and our Lord Jesus Christ, respect and love and deep faith and purity from the virtues. May God grant this seminary to grow, to be the last bastion of the faith in the United States, to be the last light God has given to the world and especially to the United States for the survival of our holy faith and holy religion. I want to encourage you, as far as I came, to encourage the seminarians. It's a work of faith, of love, and of hope. Remember that the success of whatever we do in this life depends upon our Lord Jesus Christ. It doesn't depend upon us. We fulfill our duties towards our Lord by keeping the faith, hoping in him, and loving him with our whole heart, our whole soul, and our whole strength. And the success in this life doesn't depend upon us. We have just to fight to keep the faith, growing hope and charity, and to be faithful to our Lord. The rest depends upon our Lord. What is one of the subjects that deceives Catholics? They want to see results. They want to see success, whatever they do. Our Lord never promised success or appearances of success in this life. It's why he said, the just man lives by faith. Whoever lives by faith, he doesn't see what he's doing for the glory of God. Usually he doesn't see it. You don't see usually the souls who are saved by the mass, by your prayers, by your sacrifices. You usually don't see how much our Lord loves you, or how much is your faith. You don't see that those things who are the more important in this life. Even if you don't see ahead something in appearance or something successful, doesn't matter. Remember the Japanese were many years, I think two centuries without priests. And they kept the faith, they kept the fight, they saved their souls by being faithful to our Lord Jesus Christ, to keeping the faith, keeping their hope and the charity towards our Lord Jesus Christ. This is the most important. If we do that, we will be giving God the glory. He's looking for us. He's hoping from us. And we will be united ourselves to them, to the Most Holy Trinity, to our Lord Jesus Christ, the way God wants us to do it. I repeat, the result, the success, doesn't depend upon us. And will not give it to us necessarily in this life. So, just I want to encourage you to keep going, to aim to holiness, to aim to the greatest saints, sanctity and holiness, to increase your prayer, your studies, your watchfulness upon this crisis, to be very ready to defend your faith, to be martyrs even if you are asked for it from God. Now is the moment to practice heroic virtues, heroic faith, unchecking faith, and unwavering hope and love for our Lord in the maximum possible degree. Just do that, and our Lord will fulfill in you the promise. He who is united to me, I will unite to him, and both, and the Holy Trinity will come and will make a vault upon you. You will be a heaven on earth in your soul. God will make his work upon you. He will do his will upon you the way he is planning to do it, and you will save your soul, and you will fulfill your great vocation. Become a priest, it's the right will of God, and to save many souls. Let's ask to the Blessed Virgin Mary, especially of the Mount Carmel, which is the vocation of this seminary, to protect your vocation, protect your faith, your hope, your priest, Father Hugo, to protect your faithfulness. It's no question of numbers here, it's a question of faithfulness, faith, and fight. If one of you fights, it's worth more than 10 priests or seminarians that were lukewarm and were not fighting for the faith. It's no question of numbers, it's a question of faithfulness to our Lord, to his truth, to his love. My Father, Son, and Holy Ghost, amen. Maria Purísima. Cada vez.